overlooking the Scottish city of Edinburgh stands a monument commemorating the famous mariner Vice Admiral Lord Horatio Nelson. Construction of this monument began in 1807, the same year that another mariner, James Strange Mucklejohn, was born to parents William and Isabella in the borough of Leith, better known as the Port of Edinburgh. When old enough, James began an apprenticeship in the shipbuilding trade, and a family story exists of him successfully installing a deadlight window following an unsuccessful attempt by a fellow workman on a vessel called the City of Edinburgh. A ship of this name was launched on the 27th of July 1824 from the shipyard of Menzies and Son in Leith, and was built for the Australian Company of Edinburgh in Leith. As the story goes, the captain was so impressed with this 17-year-old's ability, he offered James the chance to go to sea with him. So James sailed on the City of Edinburgh's maiden voyage on the 13th of November 1824. Departing Leith, Captain Duncan McKellar steered her for Hobart, where she arrived 5 months later on the 13th of April 1825. Offloading merchandise and passengers, the ship then sailed on to Sydney to load for the return journey, where she departed on the 21st of June for Batavia, now known as Jakarta. The following leg from Jakarta to Leith, through the Straits of Malacca, was where the story tells of James being one of 12 crew entrusted with a firearm to repel against a possible pirate attack, a threat that ultimately passed without incident. James's return to Leith and the apprenticeship must have seemed rather mundane following this adventurous voyage. However, his appetite for the sea seems to have been whetted, and as history shows from his logbooks, he was back at sea en route to New York 2 years later on the Highland Lad. For the next 9 years, James crisscrossed oceans on several vessels, visiting many Atlantic ports. Preserved within the Auckland Library are records of several of these voyages, which provide an interesting account of a 19th century sailing vessel. An insight into this young man's independent nature is illustrated through another incident. Whilst at anchor in the Peruvian port of Callao, a dispute arose with his captain. Leaving ship, he sought intervention from the local consulate. The consul favoured James's story and demanded a proper discharge and financial restitution from the captain. He also fell ill at Callao and spent time recovering in a hospital, where a Spanish priest brought him fruit and compassion. While the compassion may have been in vain, the fruit undoubtedly contributed to James's return to health, and he eventually secured voyage back to England. His practical skills as ship's carpenter and his literal ability to maintain the ship's log would have set him apart from the average mariner. Hence, when he sailed from Leith aboard the Industry of Dundee in June 1831, bound for Canada, he had attained a position of carpenter and second mate. Unknowingly, this was to be his final voyage as a single man, for amongst the emigrating passengers was a young lady by the name of Catherine Mustard, whose affections James reciprocated. Their union was to set in motion a series of events that was to prove of great significance to the development of early New Zealand.